Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of oil giant BP after it named its interim boss Murray Auchincloss as permanent CEO. BP shares are down 1%. Also in focus, shares of Renault, which reported a 9% increase in annual global sales volumes for 2023 after four consecutive years of decline. However, Renault shares are down 2% alongside other European automakers after Tesla slashed prices of its Model Y in Germany. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of shipping giants Hapag-Lloyd and Maersk, which signed an agreement for a new long-term collaboration starting February 2025. Hapag-Lloyd shares are down nearly 2%, while Maersk is up 0.5%.
In Asia, Chinese markets led losses following Beijing's disappointing GDP report. Data showed China's economy grew 5.2% in 2023, missing the 5.3% estimate. Retail sales, an important gauge of consumption, also came in slower than expected. China admits its economy is facing challenges such as insufficient domestic demand and a complex external environment, but it called a 2023 expansion hard-won.
In the past 2 to 3 years, the world economy has been in the doldrums. The international landscape has been evolving in a complex manner, and geopolitical conflicts have been frequent. So we have been facing the complexity, severity, and rising uncertainty of the external environment, as well as more cyclical and structural contradictions at home, and natural disasters have also been frequent. Such an achievement of development results amid such a complex situation was hard won.
China's economic data sent markets in the region falling to a one-month low, with the Hong Kong Hang Seng tumbling 3.7% and the Shanghai Composite slumping 2%. Here at home, the Philippine Stock Exchange Index shed 1% to return to the 6,500 level.
This market retreat today is most likely just a result of investors locking in their gains following this sizable rally. At the same time, as you mentioned, there was a regional decline in markets following the Chinese GDP report, which was a slight miss against consensus estimates. Considering that the sell-off the past 2 days have been quite aggressive, we're expecting buying interest to come back towards the end of the week.
Back to China, it vows to continue opening up its economy and improving its business environment. Speaking at the World Economic Forum in Davos, Chinese Premier Li Jiang underlined his country's progress in the past 40 years to create what he called a market-based and law-based business environment.
In the past 5 years, the rate of return on foreign direct investment in China has been approximately 9%. Which is a relatively high level, even by international standards. Therefore, I say that choosing the Chinese market is not a risk, but an opportunity. We open our arms and sincerely welcome companies from all over the world to continue investing in China.
The Philippine House Speaker begins his push for the Maharlika Investment Fund in Davos. Speaker Martin Romualdez met with leading sovereign wealth fund managers and top government officials Tuesday in a bid to open avenues for investments and collaboration. Among them, the CEO of Azerbaijan's state oil fund, Sofaz, which won a United Nations Award in 2007 for transparency in public service. Romualdez says the insights from these officials could prove invaluable in helping the Marcos administration realize its vision for the MIF as a catalyst for economic growth.